Owerri, represented by the Garrison Commander, Colonel A.Y. Bwala, the VC Federal University of Technology Owerri, Professor Chikwemeka Izzy, the Commanding Officer 342, senior officers here present, officers, gentlemen, on behalf of the Commander Task Force Artillery Brigade, it is my singular honor and privilege to welcome our guests with members of this entourage to Headquarters Task Force Artillery Brigade. Sir, in our midst this morning is the Vice Chancellor of Federal University of Technology Owerri. He is here to identify if this highly respected command and discuss other important issues. With the kind permission of the Commander, sir, please let me acquaint you with the proceedings of this visit. Firstly, I will be introducing the Garrison Commander and other staff officers here present, after which the PRO of our guest will also do his introduction. Thereafter, he will hand over the microphone to our guest and state the purpose of his visit, after which my amiable Garrison Commander will respond accordingly, which will lead us to interactive sessions where question and answer are being followed. And also, our guests will sign the visitor's book, and finally, we will all file out for group photograph. May I, at this moment, introduce you to Garrison Commander and Brigade, the Garrison Commander, sir. Next is the Commanding Officer 342, Lieutenant Colonel A.A. Sambo. Next is Major A.O. Ijaba, the Staff Officer here present. Next is the Acting Chief of Staff, Major O.P. Olukotoye, here present. Next is the Signal Officer, Captain A.O. Masuko. Next is the Military Intelligence Regiment, Major A.S. Gudus. At this moment, may I invite the PRO of our guests to please come and make his own introduction.
Of the 34 Artillery Brigade, Obinze, here represented. We are so delighted to be here, and I dare to say that FUTO is here. When I say that FUTO is here, it's because the Vice Chancellor, and in full compliment of his principal officers, the management, he is here with them. So you can see that FUTO, as it were, the Federal University of Technology, Owerri, is here in full force. And we are so delighted to be in your presence. Let me now go on to introduce the Vice Chancellor and Chancellor. He is a kind-hearted man. He is large-hearted as much as his frame is, hard-working, friendly, and I'm sure you know that already. His name is Professor Francis Chukwuemeka Eze, the Vice Chancellor. He is also here with the Deputy Vice Chancellor Administration, Professor Israel Ndukwe. Sitting next to Professor Ndukwe is the Registrar, John Nabuihe. We also have the Exchequer of the University, the Bursar, Mrs. Helen Onoha. Mrs. Onoha is the Acting Director of Physical Planning Development. This is Engineer Chima Amadi. And Chima Njofu. We also do have, seated just behind him is the coordinator of the legal unit of the university, Mr. Matobi.
Ms. Obi.
Okay, we do also have the Chief Security Officer of the University, Mr. H.I. Liang. And we have also the Chief of Staff of the Vice Chancellor. That's what we call him, is Mr. Obinze. And other staff of the University here presented. Thank you so much for having us at this courtesy call. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. The brigade commander and other officers here present. I want to start by recognizing my principal officers, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Administration, Professor Asim Bukwe, Registrar, Mr. John Nabili Uposa, Mrs. Helen Honor. And we have the acting director of the school planning, Governor Peter Magnasio, and others. We are happy to be here today. And I thank God that after all the efforts, it has materialized this day. So I want to thank God for that. We have made the concerted efforts in the past to make this visit. It wasn't possible. And on a day when we scheduled, we have engagement. Either I'm away or the commander will be away. So this time I was away for some time. And we wrote to say, let's schedule, let's put a date, and then walk towards it. And today you can see, although we scheduled this day, the commander is not here because there always the engagements here and there. But I thank God that he delegated this function to others. We were told that he will join us anytime he comes back. So I want to thank you on behalf of the council, on behalf of SEC, on behalf of the congregation, staff and students of FUTO. We have come a long way in our relationship with this command. It's a symbiotic relationship because when we are harassed, we boast that the 4th Artillery Brigade is here. We can always count on you. In the past, I know it's been a beneficial relationship because when we were talking, we were right, and we followed the right. My personal is, I know Colonel Zhang used to be here. If I remember, I used to talk with him and all that. And where we also needed to assist, we have always assisted. And I think that's the way it should be. Recently, we've had serious problems with this university. At inception, was given this land, acquired where we are staying. Over time, the problem we had that time was the founding fathers could not fence the university. So, gradually, land appreciated, encroachment started, gradually. Until we got to a stage, we know that if we kept quiet, we will lose this university. Because if you go to the books, the requirement of land for the establishment of the university at that time was a minimum of 10,000 acres, which translated to 4,408 hectares. And so, if you look at the level of encroachment, you see that what we have is the minimum. Other places like Akure has 13,000, has 10,000, if you name them. I worked in Bauchi for about 10 years. there I can't even know the boundary because the land is massive. And this is so because a university is an institution that we stay for hundreds of years, even when we've gone, it will remain. And the movement will come. We have a situation where we are going to get the teaching hospital. It will be on the museum. We have a situation where we are having a center for nuclear energy studies. It's on that. So, the same way, if we don't have enough land, or if we come short of the requirement, it means we will lose the university. So, that university has brought a lot of development. I came here in 1990, some 28 years ago. That time it was an evil forest, that's what I call it. Because we used to go to market to buy things and then we went away. So when we go and we push. But today, you can see what has happened in development in terms of having appreciated, in terms of economic well-being, in terms of ability to access education at the highest level, in terms of even employment, in terms of contract and so on. So that is where we are. And the level of encroachment brought with it serious security problems. There have been cases of rape, cases of kidnapping, cases of stealing, all over the place. Even our very expensive equipment have been stolen. So, we said, okay, maybe what we do is to start perimeter fencing. Because if we were able to fence off the school, our security will be guaranteed in a way. Because there now, everywhere, every pathway is a road. So it becomes difficult for us to control. But in doing that, we have a few people who are taking university land, they will sell the land and go to their father's place to show them. If you go there now, this physical development you see on that land are not done by people from that land. They are done by outsiders. So it's a few clique that is doing this, and alone, when you look at, you have a percentage of the land, put the investment and also sell and make a lot of money. That is where the epic is. And so we started in terms of challenges. As if you had passed through our main road, you see where our fence was pulled down. And then we have our original map. That original map is everywhere. We go to the Federal Ministry of Lands, the original map is there. If you go to State Minister of Land, the original map is there. The Gazette is also there. And in the Gazette, all the features, all the vehicles, all the things about the boundary of our map are there. So, some people from the host community have gone to court and they're lost. But they're not related. Even the two team, they reside in use. And because some of the people who are doing this are putting some money, they think they need some money and they will come to create problems for us. So, we go to Apostolic, that place you see, they are developing a state. It's written that. The state government also went in there, took about 20 hectares of university land and gave to the Federal Ministry of Housing to do a listing without our knowledge. It was when they came to me, I saw a location paper and in brackets, it's written FUTO land. So when the Minister of State came, I drew his attention to it. We took them to court. We still in court, even the photograph you have to pay, but it's in court. And I said, well, we need a housing estate, because that area is where we're going to locate a teaching hospital. So, that is part of the challenge. Now, as we are discussing, there is also massive development by the state government, what they call a mega city, on FUTO land as well. So, it becomes a problem. And the only way we can do is to request legal action, because that's all we can do. So, when we now develop to green fence, at the time, they brought to my notice again, where the name of the Nigeria put a sign post there. It's a land, keep off. And who are we to fight the village? But we belong to the central government. There is no way that we get problem among us, because the boundaries are known. You have your own map. I even had to commission a head of survey. I had to also get another expert surveyor to come so that they delineate that. And then your team, not that I was away, the DC administration took care of that. Your team came, and I took a surveyor, they looked at this thing. And from our own side, I'm told, I'm not an expert, I'm not a surveyor, that we don't even have boundary with 34 artillery brigade. And we don't have boundary. But that's by the way, because what I know is that we will always settle whatever it is. If there are special interests that we do not know, I think we will discuss that. We can always have that. The sole purpose, the main purpose of coming is for us to familiarize ourselves with you, because we should be have a symbiotic relationship. We need your assistance, and when you also need our own assistance, we will always come in. We do collaborate. You know, ours is a special university. We have, the other day we were given an award of excellence by the Air Force, because we are collaborating with them in research. I'm sure, with time, we will also collaborate with the Army. He said there are areas we can come in, because I'm a physicist. Warfare now is done in the lab. I'm sorry, I don't know that. That's what we do. Some of this work, if you want to develop a tank now, we have experts in materials that can look at what kind of material we can produce to ensure that the bullet will not be able to absorb. At least we can do together. And so, what I have also noticed is a lot of misinformation. Misinformation can create problems in the system. Because the Minister of State came here, went to the host committee, then went up with the host committee, brought him here. He first got there, met with them before coming to FUTO. And when he came, I looked at his face and I realized there was somehow, I know that they had. We started discussing. Please, let's take a trip so that I take you around our campus. You see for yourself. He said, what's the problem? I said, no. But at least, okay, come to the riverside and see what is happening. And when he came down, I said, this is what they call waterfront, is it? Waterfront by our education. He said, no. The director was there, and they said, I said, look at our bridge. Those things, if they continue, the bridge is collapsing. I didn't think it does. We're going to run into problems. Because to fix that bridge, we will be able to move on. We don't have the resources for now. So that is a So after seeing all that, he confessed. He said, I know they have done this. This state government, initially it was also misinformation. The state government revoked 75% of our land. And we went to him with all the documents. He said, no, he didn't do it. He reversed himself and gazetted it. But now, he went behind again to, let on a BFA or something like that. But that is the true story of what we are doing. So, what we are doing is for the benefit of our people, of this country. We want to ensure that your daughters, your sons, our sons, our daughters are well protected. They cannot condone a situation where people come into the university, hijack those who come by bike, the innocent students will enter the bike, only to be taken to the bush. Some of them that are women will be raped. Some of them that are men will be, disarmed, that their ancestors, whatever valuable things they have, they will be stolen. So I felt that we should come and talk to you. This is the way it is. We are credible and responsible people, and part of my understanding of the position I got at Vice Chancellor, the Vice Chancellor says, this is it, and this is it. This is there, you go there, you find that. That is our method. So, but I know that in those communities, I believe it's ignorance. I've been talking to them. I said, no amount of this infraction or encroachment will make me to deny any of those communities something we need to do for them. Because you're going to do it for other people. Why are you going to take that kind of thing? If you deny them that, if they are in good conscience, you won't feel happy. And in future, you will blame yourself for doing that. But if you empower them the way they are doing, maybe they feel, I will learn this. Recently, when we had something for clerical officers, I think computer operators, I said, get two. And they said, okay, 20 positions, we get 2 or 4 positions. And that's the way I think we should go. Because they are our people, whatever problems they have, maybe it's misinformation. And by the time some of them are now realizing, Vice Chancellor, I have a 5-year tenure. At the end of it, I will leave. The 3 years time, I will retire. I'm not going to go with this plan, but I want, when I come back to FUTO, I said, I left a legacy to FUTO. If not for this man, this year wouldn't have been there. If not for this man, we would have lost this university. Keep telling them, the implications of what you are doing is that if we can no longer have a place to develop here, and another section of the state, we say, okay, come over to our place. We have lost. And the better things are coming up. So, I want us to see ourselves as partners in progress. Because we are here. We belong to the same federal government. We work for federal government. And we feel that since we are our neighbors, anytime it happens, we do what we used to do. We will write and we will shout and say, please, even if it's a patrol, once your vehicle passes through our road, it's a same signal that look, the military is here, not playing again. So I want to thank you for welcoming us and pray that the good Lord will grant our request to have a more harmonious relationship. We pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
At this moment, my immigrant terrorism commander, Colonel A.Y. Bwala, will respond accordingly, which will lead us to interactive sessions where question and answer are before the garrison commander, sir.
Chancellor of Federal University of Technology, Owerri, Professor Francis Chukwuemeka, other members of the interest, the commanding officer of the 42 in the regiment, principal staff officers of the brigade. Good afternoon. On behalf of the brigade commander, who accidentally went for General Officers Commanding Executive Division's conference, he left on Sunday. The conference took place yesterday, the official I was serving in the evening. As now as we are speaking, he's on his way back to the station. He would have been here to receive you, but around 8:30 there was a blockage between Kigwe to Inugu, where I think along the line a policeman shot a driver and drivers blocked the road. That's been hasty for women along the general axis. So he directed that I should receive you on his behalf. We are grateful for your coming. We are grateful because as neighbors we have to know each other and cooperate. Because this is our country and we are serving the same government in a different capacity. It is through you we get education, and it is through us we try to provide security for our nation, Nigeria. We have listened to your predicament, especially in terms of land. Land in this part of the country is very difficult to have. When I was in Maiduguri, the University of Maiduguri land is so vast. Because of this insecurity that they start fencing part of that expensive land. Here, as you said, the government was informed since Land Use Act decree stated that lands belong to government. The government on their own can give, can take without notice. And the state government too, from me, what they did, they would have consulted you, having your land, that you want to use it for this. The land belongs to them, but it is acquired by the federal government. The federal institution should be known that this is what you want to do. But unfortunately, they have taken your land and made buildings, which to me, as you said, you have gone to court and the court, I believe, will give judgment in your favor. Concerning our boundary, as you stated, clearly we don't have a boundary with FUTO. At the same time, if you have visited, we believe we'll be working in harmonious entities so that we can be able to have a defined boundary. Our mappings and survey department of the Nigerian Army, we invite them to look at our maps and see where our boundary ends and where your own start. That will go a long way in solving land infringement by the host communities near us. On our own land, we discovered that even behind our barracks in our range, the host community has started infringing into our lands. We continue to talk to them that this lands was given as far back when the military regimes of First Republic or Second. And as a custodian of land, as a leadership, we find it difficult to do something without the army help of us. Just like FUTO cannot do anything without the Ministry of Education. So we continue to work in harmony and we give our best so that this further relationship will continue to be cordial and will continue to meet. Any time two organizations meet together, it is the beginning of good things to happen. your operation far, we're operating far, and by your visit, this will cement a good relationship. In terms of security, you are close to us. You know there are migrants who go there, especially that bridge before you go to the upper village. You always see you smoking Indian hemp, especially in the night. We will try to make sure we provide patrol to cover that area. At any time, you have anything, don't hesitate. Your security officer can call, or agency officer can call, or military police officer can get in touch with us so we can dispatch our drug to secure your property and your students. As you said, we need expansion, especially the nuclear department. One day I took a drive inside the school, I saw it. I went in to look for my former supervisor. I don't know whether he's still alive or he's still in the service, Professor Uwago. He was my supervisor in the university. So I drove around to look for him, asking one or two people whether I can drop him. The last time I saw him was 1990. So we'll try our best to provide security at any time you need. As I said, we are a land department and the army marketing and survey who invite them. So we'll have a definite communication between our family. Our parents are so the fence being broken down. It may be our hoodlums who are trying to look for one area or two. Because as I said, land in this part of the country is a precious matter. You can buy a land today, somebody will sell it again to somebody tomorrow, and the village will come. You need to reform that you have paid the elderly. You have let give our own. Why do you develop, start developing on this land? All these things you can do. I'm just on behalf of the Brigade Commander, but you have checked when he comes, we will brief you accordingly. And this relationship will continue. I know our wards, you apply for university and you have been granted us vacancies. Relationship will continue. We have mess. We invite you to our mess so you can sit down and relax in a good atmosphere. We have some of your lecturers who are members of our mess. Some of your lecturers are members of Arsenal Golf Club. It's our avenue that we sit down together and understand ourselves more and more. So once again, on behalf of the Brigade Commander, the Brigadier General Chef Baturi, we most sincerely appreciate your visit and we thank you for finding this great time to be with us out of your tight schedule. This meeting will not end. We will continue to meet. We will pay a special visit to you to familiarize ourselves with your department, what is happening. So I'm asking you, would like to read masters. So I'm asking you, would like to get admission to read our first degree. Just because the military were like full line. Today you are here, tomorrow you posted out. As you spend 2 years, 3 years. But the young one under us can stay for 4, 5, 6 years, especially our soldiers. So sir, we are really grateful. We are honored for your visit. And we pray that we are channeled in witness developmental affairs in the university for better mental for our people and our country, Nigeria. Once again, you are welcome and thank you. God bless.
Then an answer has been called, if any.
Nobody comes. You know, someone may have something in his mind. He wants to do something. But he wants to be scared of it.
His wife is still working with us. So he just retired in November last year. So we can link you up with him.
Well, they are teenagers, I'm glad for him.
Okay. The Brigade Commander. All protocols observed I just want to thank God that we're here today, actually. Because when the bison were traveled, some patients traveled, I was there on the ground when some delegates from this command came across for the same issue. And I want to thank God and believe that exactly what I told them that day was what my present love is repeating here. That there is no cause for trouble between us and the command, because we belong to the same establishment that the Israeli community serves. And that is what he has said here today. It may be absolutely necessary because you also pointed it out. You know, it's like the easy just summarized. But the feelings are strong in FUTO that rumors are making their waves in their rounds. By 1980, for instance, the dollar was 55 kobo or less. 1980. People were sending money from here to the US, to our people in the US. So that 10,000 naira at that time would naturally mean about 10 million naira now. So the young people, their fathers were so interested. This university placed here, different groups vied to have it located in their place. What they wanted this university in their place. By saying, or what I wanted in that place. But by the special grace of God, this place is now hosting the University of Technology. The compensation for this land acquired was fully paid with every evidence. But what they are saying, some of them are saying, particularly those that are informed, those that are almost abusing their parents by saying, why did they sell at such cost? Or why did they receive only such small, without knowing the value of the naira at the time compensation was paid. That is the issue. Because when you understand it very clearly, even when some of their rumor mills come around you to give you misinformation, because many of you are not from here, when they come to paint this gory picture of our taking their land from them, you will understand the background of it all. From that time, what this university, this single university is equivalent to about 25 giant industries in terms of the contributions to the economy of this area called many of their children. I was the admissions officer for 5.5 years. Even part of when the PC, at the time the PC was the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Education, till he became PC, we know how many of their students, provided they were qualified, were given admission, who couldn't have gotten admission, who couldn't have gone to school at all, or gone to university, but they were trained. The registrar here has records of how many of their people are being given jobs here. One room in Iyawa at that time could have been about 1,000 naira or 500 naira. But now one room is about 120,000 naira. So if you think of the economy, what FUTO is contributing to the economy of this system. And when anything is established here, it is not people from my place, it is not people from your place that will come to work here. Particularly at the lower level, it is kill people from their own place here. Anything that is established here, like the medical college, like all of, okay, we need to start from outreach programs. We supply medical services to them. We supply complementary services to them. We supply so many other services to them. Even help them to, whenever they have some certain needs which we can take care of, we do all these things. Now, if we establish a college of medicine here, they are going to benefit most, because when my own children are sick somewhere, so we find out that all these things are the reasons for which we want to apply them. So when they come around telling you stories of this, the benefits of this university to those communities, they are enormous. I just want to once again thank the Vice Chancellor for bringing us to this place today to interact with this command, and believe very strongly, like the commander told, that this meeting today will bring forth much more good guidance to the benefits of the army, ourselves, and the entire host communities, in Jesus' name.
Meteorological institutions and the appropriate one. And the trip came 2004 commission. So we have bonds here. Our therapist is we have probably will come back to you so you can conduct a research for you. For the religious definition they will come. And as you said, with this your information, they know they come here, we'll tell them not possible. So that's what we're going to do. We always advise them, as we said, after 1980 and as now, things are different. I was opportunity to mediate between two communities of wild producing community. They are calculating that the government or the company should pay them 3 trillion naira, calculating from 1946 to now, which is not possible. The price of crude oil then, the price now. What will happen? What will happen if things right? This is Nigeria, this is the nation. People can continue to talk. We always do your best, and your best will continue to protect and give you that grace, that knowledge to understand how to handle the moments. The youth then, they don't know anything. Not because they took any types of drugs, and the debt is nothing for them. They don't have to think of their future and future of their children tomorrow. We continue, but we will try our best. I said, anything, anytime you have a problem, just call us. I'm going to be in shape and you need to cover our spirit. Thank you very much. Try to present a flag for you so that you can find a place in your office and then
keep it. Remember that it was time to start by the
You can sit down and take your things and join us later.
Okay.
Yeah, you can sit down. After taking your things, come down.
Okay.
Then I'm not going to go to the hospital.